Hi everybody, welcome to our new video, and I would like to say thanks for watching this video and supporting us. What we're going to do now, we're going to learn how to configure your modem with your RAN 4G SIM card. We're using a Huawei B315, but it doesn't matter which modem you're going to use as long as it takes a SIM card. So now there are a couple of things which can some of you which can make this operation not to work 100% is, one, first of all, the network coverage of your area. Two, we expect that your card is already registered and activated. Sometimes you can have, it can happen like the card you're using is not activated. That's why you don't see your card is working. So one trick to see if the card is activated. Remember, RAN, they don't have a 3G cards. 3G cards, they have 4G cards. All RAN SIM cards, like this one is a RAN what SIM card, all of them, they are starting from 4G to 5G, right? This is a 4G, right? You can see it. It's a 4G. So since it's a 4G card, go and put it in your cell phone, like a 4G cell phone. You get me? Like this. Put in the SIM card. Once you put in the SIM card, if you see the network showing you like RAN, like this, there is no SIM card here. But if we can put the SIM card inside here, it will need us to do some couple of things and it will take time. So to make sure that your SIM card is working, is activated anyway, you take out the SIM card, put it in a phone of 4G, not 3G card. Mind you, RAN SIM cards, they do not work in a 3G dongle or in any 3G modem, because 3G can't use a 4G SIM card. Only a 4G modem can use a 3G card. But a 3G phone and a 3G modem cannot use a 4G, because a 4G SIM card is newer than a 3G whatever modem, right? Good. So now the only thing you have to do is have your modem with you, get your SIM card with you. In most cases, some modems like this, they take a big SIM card, they don't take nano and micro. So here we have to wrap up some things. Here we have to put this SIM card into this housing. So what happened, we're gonna break away this. This is something I got from Vodacom SIM card. So I'm gonna break it to use it as, yeah, my, all these SIM cards, I think the company which makes them is the same. So good enough, you can use each and any company's what SIM card. Then yeah, it's fine. Let me do this. Yo, that's great. Crazy for me. I don't want to waste a lot of time for you guys. So once you've done that, put the SIM card here inside this. Okay. But now it depends which modem you're using. If the modem is using a nano, then you're gonna use a nano. Give me 2 seconds, I do that. Let me pause the video, then I fix the SIM card issue, then we come back. Well, we're done with fixing that SIM card issue. So don't worry about the color, it's not red. I just used just a Vodacom housing to put it in. So right, so what you're gonna do, you're gonna put it in your modem like this. If you're using the same modem I'm using, if you're using a different modem, also you should figure out how to do that. So guys, everything I'm teaching here is just for education what purposes, nothing else more than that. Just this to educate you, there's nothing else I'm teaching but to educate people how to do this. So this video is intended to teach people how to do things for education purposes. So anything beyond that, I'm not responsible, and you're not allowed to use the knowledge you get here for something else, right? Okay, that's good. So secondly, you have your modem like this. I'm sure you might see this modem is customized. We customized this modem. It's not the same as the one you have. The one you have might the same modem, but it might not have these two things, right? So now the one you have might have a white or black charger. So what we do, what we call it, you plug it in here first. Okay, once we plug it in here, what are we gonna do? We're gonna get this and put it in power. Okay, it's gonna be like that. I'm gonna put it in power somewhere. Plugging something in power is not something difficult, even if I don't show you that. It's getting here on the wall. Once you put it in power, it's gonna bring power here. Give it time. All the lights should be on. I'll tell you each and every light, what is it for. The first one is for power. Second one is for internet. The third one is for... So if you see your modem showing red, just know that you don't have network. There's no network. The SIM card is not registered or there's no network. But now it has to turn like this. Once it turns like this, simply means that you are 100% sure connected, right? Here it means the signal strength. If it's in 3, just knows that 100% that is fine. Super good. So these two lights, this one is for Wi-Fi. This one is for what? For LAN cable. Once you put in a LAN cable, it's going to show. So the Wi-Fi one should be on or off. So if it's off, then you should make sure you switch on your Wi-Fi. You get me? So if the Wi-Fi is off, then you can reset the modem if you don't know how things work, right? But it should be on now. Let me press the W's. Okay, so that's fine. Let's leave things the way they are, right? But also the Wi-Fi one should work. So if it doesn't work, there should be something wrong with the modem or whatever. Don't worry about that. We don't care about that. So what I'm gonna show you now is to see if the modem is working 100%. So once I put in the LAN cable here to the computer, then you're gonna see what? You're gonna see things gonna change. Why? This gonna light, right? Let's go to the computer first. I'm gonna log into the computer and I say, okay. Once I log into the computer, I don't have internet here, so I'm gonna click here. Nothing's going on. You can see if I try to go to, let me say Facebook, then I say enter. You see it say there's no internet. Once there's internet, it's gonna show somewhere here. So let's give it internet because we already fine with our modem. Everything's 100% fine. So what we do, we're gonna use a LAN cable for our computer. So what we're gonna do is to plug in this. Put in the LAN cable here. So once you put it in there, it clips in there, so it should show here. Yes, it lighting. You see, once it start lighting, just know that you're good to go, right? Good. So now let's go to our computer. We see the computer now, what's going on with the computer? You see, it's brought this little network thing. So if I decide to go to any site, I would go to also which site, any site we say, maybe Google boy .co.za. Let's see, it should go there. If you take in time, yeah, look, it's here. Simple, good. Now what are we gonna do? We're gonna do our speed test. Okay, and say speed test. So test our speed, we run and see. Wow, it's running on 15 megabytes per second, which is super good. 12, 11, upload. See? Well, the results are good, but now what happens when you don't see if your SIM card is registered or not? So if it happens like your SIM card is not registered, what we'll tell you is put the SIM card into your phone. Once you don't see rain or any network, they just know there are two things. It's not registered or it's what? There's no network in that area. So what you do, put the SIM card in your phone, walk around, get out of your house. Maybe you can go 1 kilometer, 500 meters away. Then you see if you have a network. If you have network there and you come here, you don't have network, then simply means you have to get a bigger modem or something else, right? So, but if you never registered your SIM card, what you do, you go to rain.co.za, then you hit enter. Once you're there, you will see all this. You say allow, it's okay. Then once you do, scroll down, and you're gonna see something like go for your SIM card unlimited whatever checkout, get your first SIM card activation now. Look, you say got your 4G SIM card, yes, activate now. You click on activate now, then you say activate SIM. I say take a lot, just click a button and whatever. So okay, get SIM card from, okay, leave that. You say activate now, great. So when you go there, it's gonna tell you create account, one, choose your plan, two, three, register payment details for Rika online in Mint. So simple, these steps are simple. When you say get started, then it's gonna ask you if you are a South African using the ID, the process becomes very simple. But if you are a foreign nation, so it's gonna be a problem, using a passport, it's okay, but it takes a little bit longer, right? I also find something from other clients I help. They told me one of them tried to register from online. They gave him an option that, no, listen, we're gonna deliver for you the SIM card which is already registered, which is fine. Okay, anyway, that's what he told me. But what I wanna tell you, you can register the SIM card there where you are. Some people, if you're using ID, sometimes takes maybe 30 minutes, sometimes hour or two, the SIM card is working 100%, right? Where do you get SIM card? Walk in 2 clicks, ask for that SIM card. If not, then you can go to Rain SIM card, Rain website, then you say, go down here and say, get your SIM card delivered now. You click there. Once you click there, you say, order now. Remember, they're not going to charge you for that. Okay. Then you find your restaurant, whatever, and you will see the steps to do that, right? You can ask also, as I say, you can do take a lot. You can do, you can go to clicks. You walk in 2 clicks, then you get your SIM card. They give you a SIM card. Once they give you a SIM card, you bring it home. Then you activate it online yourself without bothering anyone or spending more time. So guys, that's the way we do check your stuff. We'll create other more videos if you ask some questions, but for now, this is the way you configure your whatever. You don't have to do a lot of things. Put it in a modem, then you will go to go. So setting up Wi-Fi and whatever, we'll do those videos on how to set a Wi-Fi, whatever. So but now we use the LAN cable to do that. So if you have a question, please ask us. We're gonna come back to you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.